Hello and welcome to my how to use FendMod parts, and today I want to show you how you can use the gyroscope and the chemical lift engines in combination with the angle sensor and some propellers to make something that can fly and is easy to control. And don't forget, if something got changed in the update, maybe there is a new information in the item description. For example, on the chemical lift engine, there is a new change in the input. You don't need to add a NAND gate to invert the signal for the descent. You can just now use two normal inputs, and the second input is painted in any different color, like with the other stuff from my mod. So I want to keep that similar to other stuff in the usage. So that is why I changed that in the chemical lift engine. And what you can do with the stuff is basically a flying machine like this. I can press the left mouse to fill up the balloon, or the right click mouse to empty it again, to get down. And the gyros at the front are for auto stabilizing, and yeah, the propellers for forward flying. It's a really good flying vehicle, and it's pretty cheap and easy to buy. And how that works, I will show you in a second. I need to land again. Especially what I want to show is the auto balancing with the new change in the angle sensor. It's pretty easy to set up. For that flying machine here, we need exactly that part amount plus a chemical tank. So we need 8 small straight pipes, 6 bearings, 2 corner pipes, 1 chemical lift engine, a chemical tank, 4 angle sensors, 4 WASD converters, 2 propellers, 1 left, 1 right. If someone has the question in mind why left and right, yeah, look at the rotor, at the blade shapes. One spins left around anti-clockwise to produce forward speed, and the other one must spin clockwise to produce forward speed. That is why I have 2 different propellers for each side. Then we need 5 gyros. Only 2 are for tilting and pitching. The 3 other are for counterforcing, like a suspension glitch, but my gyros are way better than a suspension glitch because it's a single part and it doesn't use any glitch. It's a straight code, clean, and it works pretty well, and it doesn't hit the performance if you play multiplayer with a lot of suspension glitches. You know, the creations freak out. With that part, not, or way less. Sure. So, and we need a seat. Level is not important from all of the stuff, if I see that right. The only thing that you can upgrade is the seat and the controller. Oh, sorry, I forgot the controller. We need 1 controller. And that must be level 5 for the speed. You can counteract that with more bearings, but I think a level 5 controller is good to have. So, and I think I will start with the how to build. It's pretty quick and easy. First we need chemical container, then the CLD just at the front, 1 gyro like this. Let me look that I do it the same. Yeah. So then we need the angle sensors. You can see they have this side, then they have the top side. So how you place them is basically like that. This is a wrong way around. The front is this with the tip of the arrow, and the top side is this here at the top. So the front, the end of the arrow is the front facing side, and the here the begin from the arrow is the upside. And if you want to detect an angle, if the arrow, the tip of the arrow goes down, it turns on. And you can set a threshold for that turning on here with the slider. That is not an angle, that is only a threshold. So it turns not direct on if the moment when another sensor on the other side turns off. So you get the weird flipping back and forward, back and forward. And for that is the slider to prevent. So, and we need to place the angle sensors with the arrow tip to the front in my direction now. Oh, come on. So, one here. I placed that only temporarily to place that against this. So you can see one tip is here and one is here. So it's going in this way and this way. Then we need to paint one of the angle sensors in any other color than the default color and connect it straight to the gyro. That is how you set up a balancer for one axis. That is now for the pitch axis, for up and down. And now we can place for left and right roll. One more here. And to save space, I place them like this here. Come on, arrow tip, where are you? Like this. And to place that the same way, I make it like so. One tip is here and one is here. And again, just paint one of the inputs differently. And we check later if that was the right one. We can switch the colors later. So place that here. Turn that a little bit down because we don't need that much power in the air because there is no force that holds the creation in the air in any way. So, and I think that was for the auto balancing everything. And now we can place. I do it a little bit different. One here for the counteracting for pitch up and down, so it slows down the own rotation speed. And we can place one more here, just one more for counteracting the force of the first gyro. A little bit more. So, and then we need the last gyro. We can throw it basically anywhere we want. That is for turning left and right with A and D. Just place it here on top, turn that a little bit down, and then we need two WAs and D controller for A and D. Connect them to the gyro for left and right, and paint one of that input any other color. Seat. And then we can, for testing, connect that here. So then we need two more WAs and D controller. I place them here. I place them a little bit weird because so we can see that easier. On this creation I placed them more compact, but that is not important here right now. So I make here the right click and here the left click from the mouse. Let's see, left and right. Again. That is the new change. The two inputs here are for the CLE, for the chemical lift engine, and the second input must be in any other color. So connect that to the CLE and the seat. The CLE to the chemical tank, and you can fill up it on this way if you are in creative or with unlimited commands. You can use my command fill. Just aim at the tank and type in fill, and it is complete filled with that item that can fill up the tank. It's one of the commands. So, if I have everything done, that is left, that is right, that is up, and that is down, and we can see that the angle sensor must be painted differently. Whoop. So, a little bit more force in that direction. Whoop. Okay, and we need to switch the colors from them here to. So, and increase the power that is a matter of testing. So, and to stop that wobble, what we see here right now, you can increase that slider here. How is that? The threshold. You must test what value is good for your creation, depends on how wide and big and heavy your creation is. That is, yeah, you need to test that. So, and I do here the same, around 10. If it's positive or negative, you need to test that. So, and then we can go up, and how you can see, it's already balancing. It has still a little bit of a wobble, but we can fix that by lowering that down or that up. The counterforce bearings, gyros. Well, is that not enough? Ah, scroll it down. So, that is to make it balancing and flying. And now for forward fly, it's pretty easy to set up. Controller. Ah, not this. And we can go here, and again the same. So, and here we can just straight wire the seat to the controller and the controller to every bearings. And flip one side, turn that up, all bearings, full speed and loop. Ah, that was the wrong way around, so we can spin that in this direction and this direction. Everything. No, that wrong way. Playing with the values is, how I said, a little bit of adjustment work, but at the end you will get it working. Okay, this version is not so good balanced, but yeah. Oh, it flips. What? Ah, I messed up something. Come on, let me down. So, left and right is... Maybe it must go in the opposite direction. Ah, that looks better, I think. Yeah. So, this was how you can set up. To make it good working, you need to play a lot more with the placing of the position from blocks and the weight, because it's a flying machine. And if you make it better, not like my version now, this version is much better, you see, because it's much better balanced at the front. And yeah, you need to test and play around with all that stuff. But I think that is the fun in the game, to find the way how you make it. And yeah, we have the blocks that allows you to make an auto balancer with not a lot of performance leaks, and yeah. This is how you use the gyro, the angle sensor, the CLE, yeah, all this stuff. I hope you have fun with that, with the new part, and I wish you a nice day, and we see us next time. Bye bye, guys.